Hey everyone, and welcome to Photoshop Pro Help. And today I'll be teaching this really cool aged paper effect. Now it's really fast and pretty simple to make. Now there are a few things that you're going to be needing to make this effect. So let's jump over to it. You're going to be needing this paper, which I found on sxc.hg, which is a stock image website which I use quite a bit. So if you haven't seen them, go check them out. The link is going to be in the description bar for this precise image. And if you don't want to do that, you can download all the source files that you'll need to make this effect from my website. So that's also going to be in the description bar, so check that out. So once you have loaded your image that you are going to use in Photoshop for this effect, we're going to just start work. So let's jump over to my image. So we're going to go over to image, adjustments, and black and white, and that changes that to black and white. And we're just going to go and play around with the colors now. So we're going to go over to the reds, just work your way down. So all these settings are going to be totally different for each image, so you're going to have to play around with this by yourself. So I'm just going to go and quickly do this because you're going to have a lot more time than me. So I'm making things a little bit darker, and maybe if you've got trees, a little bit lighter, so we have the contrast. If you have a really cool sky like this, I'd probably suggest make it a little bit darker, because we are going to lighten it up a little bit later. So once you have done that, we're just going to go and hit tint, because we need that aged color to it. So we're going to bring the saturation up a tad, not too much, because we don't want it bright orange. So the hue is going to be around 42 and the saturation is going to be around 26. You can follow my steps on that one because they don't really change per image. So once you've done that, you're going to go and click OK. And once we've done this, we're going to go over to the paper. And from here, all you're going to go and do is hit the magic wand tool, and that can be hiding under the quick selection tool. So hold and click to bring up the menu and hit magic wand tool. And we're just going to go and click the white behind, and we're going to press Control, Shift and I on our keyboard to inverse the selection. We're going to go up to the move tool on the left hand side at the top, and we're just going to go and drag the paper to our document. From here we're going to hold Alt to zoom out, press Control and T to free transform, and we're just going to turn this around so it's the right angle for this, and then we're just going to drag in so it's the right size for this. So you want to play around, you want to make sure that you've got all the detail in the actual paper, so all the detail on the background image you want on the paper, because we are cutting the rest off. So once you have done that, you want to make sure that you have got a little bit around the sides though to cut off. So once you've done that, we're just going to go and click the tick icon at the top that holds it into place, and we're just gonna press Control on our keyboard and click the little thumbnail in the layers panel which selects it. Press Control, Shift and I to inverse the selection again. Press the background layer twice so it becomes an editable layer, and then go and click OK, and then we're just gonna hit delete on our keyboard so that deletes the background and cuts out. Press Control and D to deselect, and we're going to go back to the paper one, and we're just going to go and change the blending mode to multiply. Now it's pretty dark at the moment, so all we're going to go and do is go to our image, proper image, so the bottom layer, and we're just going to go to the adjustments. So we're going to go to this black and white circle on the bottom right side, click that, and we're just going to go to curves. Now you're going to be playing around with the curves because these are going to be totally different for each image depending on how dark your image is. So from here what we're going to get is a washed out faded effect. So we're going to start from the middle and we're just going to bring it up so it's a little bit white, so round about there, and then we're just going to curve it a little bit. So you want to play around with that, because you're going to have a lot more time, as I said. Once you have done that, we're just going to go to our bottom image. We're going to go to the bottom right hand side, sorry, and go to the new blank icon, and we're just going to go and hit the paint bucket tool. Make sure you've got the foreground color to white, and then we're just going to go and click that, and then we're just going to bring that layer to the bottom, and that's pretty much the effect done. Now you can add loads of loads more bits, like we're going to add a drop shadow to the paper. So you can go to the paper layer, double click that, and we're just going to put a drop shadow on. Now depending on the angle of your paper or your picture, so you might want to play around with the angle. So mine's going to be probably about 140 for this, and then we're just going to bring out the distance so we can see it, and the size so it's not so blocky, so it's a little bit faded around the edges. And now once you have done that, you can click OK. Now as I said, you can add loads more bits to this. You can even add masking tape like I did to the original. From here you can just go to Google, find the masking tape, or go to stock images and find masking tape on there, or just even normal tape would do. Once you have got an image of masking tape, I just go to found this one, you just cut it out with the rectangle marquee tool on the left hand side, drag and drop into your image, and press Control and T, depending on the size or that it comes out on, to the right shape, and press the tick icon at the top. You're going to go to the magic wand tool again and just click the white, and then press delete, and press Control and D to deselect, and then Control T to free transform, and then you can really put it anywhere that you want, so around about there. So we're going to go and click the tick icon at the top, and you can even just bring down the opacity a little bit so you can just see through it. So once you've done that, you might want to bring out the canvas size because it is a little bit tight at the moment. So we're just going to go over to image and canvas size, and we're just going to go to pixels because we can see what we're working with, and all I'm going to do is bring this up by 200 pixels on the width and the height. So this is going to be set to 2000, and I'm just going to bring up to 1400 for the height, and then just click OK. I'm going to go to the paint bucket tool again, go to the bottom layer, click, and that's pretty much the effect done. Now how easy and simple was that? Now you can add your own effects onto it. Don't stop there, let your imagination go wild, put your own sort of thing on it, and please check out my website, please comment, rate and subscribe, and I'll see you next time guys, bye for now.